This Sunday marks the 60th Lei Feng Day, an annual event to commemorate the late young soldier Lei Feng, who devoted his spare time and money to helping the needy. Lei Feng was an ordinary young Chinese soldier in the 1960s. He died in an accident in 1962 at the age of 22. In 1963, Chairman Mao Zedong called on the nation to learn from him. Each year's March the 5th has been designated as Lei Feng Day. Over the past decades, young people have developed an appreciation for role models from a variety of different backgrounds. However, the changes do not mean that the Lei Feng spirit is losing its luster. At his birthplace, Wangcheng district of Changsha in central China's Hunan, crowds of people are commemorating Lei Feng.
最近几天的人流量应该是从上个星期开始都超过了5000, 尤其是周末，上个周末已经过了2万人了，所以人民群众学习雷锋的热情是非常高涨的。
In fact, the desire to help others can always be found among ordinary people, and the spirit of Lei Feng is still inspiring a new generation of Chinese people.
妈妈从小就跟我讲雷锋叔叔的故事，我觉得他好伟大呀，我长大以后也想像他一样，做一个关爱他人、乐于助人的人。尊老爱幼是中华民族的传统美德，在雷锋纪念日，我们来走访，问为了家中有困难的同学和留守的老人，将温暖送给他们，我觉得非常有意义。
In China, Lei Feng has become a cultural icon representing people who are ready and willing to help others. In Liaoning, a service group at Dalian Railway Station is serving the passengers with the Lei Feng spirit.
火车站的服务人员、工作人员对我们的细心、热心、照顾，像来到家一样。我们感觉到雷锋就活在我们身边。雷锋精神照亮了一代又一代人。
我要立足岗位，在平凡的岗位上主动奉献，从一点一滴做起，坚持多问一句，多走一步，多帮一把，让南来北往的旅客出行体验更加美好。In
Qingdao, East China's Shandong, a group of young volunteers are taking out photos of the elderly for free to give them a beautiful memory.
我们要深刻把握雷锋精神的时代内涵。 加强志愿服务，让学雷锋活动融入到日常生活中。
In Wuhan's Jianghan district, medical workers are offering medical services at the doorstep of local residents.
这个小区是一个老旧社区，今天我们是送医上门，这些老人呐，特别欣慰，也特别开心，让他们走不绝户，享受。 我们学习雷锋践行中的实际的住房。